Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we are going to learn a concept that is return on average capital employed formula. One of the really significant ratio. See, we can see over here the formula return on average capital. So we are finding what? Return on the capital employed. So over here it's going to be earning before interest and income tax. So EBIT, which is known as your operating profit, divide by your capital employed. But your capital employed is what? Average. This is very important. Let's understand the return on ROACE formula, that is return on capital employed. Now, why the investor invests in a company? Why do they invest in a company? See, it's because they want to grow with the company. Return on average capital employed basically helps them to find out whether they should invest in the company or not. Now, this is important. This is a significant part. So, ROACE formula is not similar as return on capital employed. It is not similar to ROCE. Here we are calculating the return on the average capital. That's why we need to consider both the beginning capital and the ending capital employed. Now, ROACE formula is basically your profitability ratio, and it helps the investor to find out how much return they may get from the investment they would make in a company. Let's understand the formula. ROACE is equal to your EBIT, earning before interest and tax, divided by your average capital employed. So this is your formula. Now, let's understand this with a simple example so that we get some clear idea. Let's take a simple example to illustrate ROACE formula. There's this company called Benefit Inc. And it has some following information, something like this. It has your EBIT, which is your $30,000. Then it has some beginning capital, that is big cap. Let's say it is $54,000. And the ending capital, let's say $4,50,000. So, over here, what we need to find? We need to find ROACE formula. So first we need to find out the average capital employed over here. So our average capital employed is going to be your beginning capital, right, plus your ending capital. So this is the summation. This is your summation. You need to divide this by 2 to get average, right? The beginning capital and the ending capital. I'm sorry, this should be 5,40,000, right? So we get 4,95,000 average capital employed. Now, using this return on average capital formula, we get ROACE formula. That is, ROACE formula is basically your EBIT divided by average capital employed. So let's divide this. The average capital employed, this is 4,95,000. Sorry, our EBIT we need to divide, 30,000 divided by average capital employed. We get our answer as, just convert this into percentage, we get 6%, so 6.06, close enough to that. So 6% is the return on average capital employed. So this was basically a hypothetical example. But now let's understand this with the help of a real life example, and we'll take a company called Nestle. Nestle's return on average capital employed. Now, this is a screenshot of the consolidated income statement as on 31st December 2014 and 2015 for Nestle. And you can see the operating profit that has been highlighted over here, which is 12,408 for 2015 and 10,905 for 2014, right? We need another thing, that is the capital employed. So we need to go down and check out the total current liability, which is 33,321 and 32,895. And if we go down a little bit, we get our total liabilities and equity as 123,992 and 133,450. So here, there are three figures that are important, and all of them are highlighted. right in front of us, the current liability, the total liability and equity, and the operating profit, right? And for 2014 and 2015 both, and then the total assets and the total current liability for 2014-15. So let's consider the operating profit for 2015, right? The operating profit is 12,408. So let's jot down some numbers over here. The operating profit. Let's pick up the numbers from here. 12,408 and 10,905. 12,408 and 10,905. This is for 2015 and this is for 2014. Now, then we have the capital employed, right? We have 123,992. Okay. And we need to deduct the total current liabilities from that. So we'll take the figures over here. 123,992 minus 33,33,321. So that is 90,671. That's your capital employed for 2015. And for 2014, it's 133,450 and 32,895. So let's deduct that. 133,450 less 32,895. That will give us this two particulars. So this is your capital employed. Capital. And this was basically your operating profit. Right? So based on this, we can calculate the average capital, right? Should be quite easy. The opening capital plus your closing capital. This whole thing divide by 2. I'm not putting in brackets. So 95,613 is our average capital. And our formula, if we just apply return on average capital employed, ROACE, is going to be your operating profit 12,408 divided by your average capital, and convert this in percentage, we get our answer as 12.98%, or that is 13%. Now on the next note, if we see, we need to understand the explanation part of the return on the average capital employed formula. See, in this above ratio, we have two parts. The first part, the first and the foremost part, is our EBIT, the earning before interest and tax. See, EBIT is actually your operating income. Now, if we look at the income statement, the P&L as we call, of the company, we would see that after deducting the operating expenses from the gross profit, we get the operating income, or which is known as your EBIT. And you may ask, why are we taking EBIT into consideration instead of net income? There should be this question. It's because, you know, the operating income directly reflects the income generated, from the business. Moreover, operating income does not include income from the other sources. Okay, so make sure that. The second important criteria in our formula, the part, is the average capital employed. So this is the second part. See, the first approach is that, you know, if we can simplify, add your equity and your long-term debts, if any. But there is a second approach which is better than the first approach. In the second approach, we deduct. What do? We deduct the current liabilities, the CL, from the total assets, or we can add up the equity and the non-current liability. The second approach is better because it directly shows that what has been directly invested in the business, meaning this approach also includes any other sort of non-current liabilities other than debt. Now this is your calculator for your formula. If we put EBIT over here, let's say 5 lakh, and your average capital employed as, let's say, 1 million. So your average capital employed is going to be 50%. Now keeping this average capital employed as same, if we reduce this as to $4,50,000, your ratio is going to go down, and if we increase this, the ratio is going to go up. So you can make your own conclusion, put your numbers, and get some amazing results out of this.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.